you ever done a fast before, then this would be your first. If you started many fasts before and you never finished them, then let this would be the one you start and finish. Am I right about that?
Yes.
Amen. If you've done them many times before, then let this one be for something for somebody else other than yourself. There's always a great opportunity for us as a body of Christ to pray and fast together.
Yes.
And I believe that God wouldn't have given these tools to us if they weren't needed. And so today I want to just talk to you for a few moments. I didn't come to really preach to you this morning. I just wanted us to start together and finish together. You guys remember initially we talked about the 40 days. But God just kept working with me because he knows he has to say some things to me more than once. And then after talking with my wife as well, I said, let's not do 40 days. It's just going to drag it longer than most people are willing to say. But some of us, we just don't have good stick-to-it discipline power. And so I plead to people to get me. This is a great frame for us. And take it one day at a time. And then now, do me a favor. One day David said, this is not about a diet. You want to have a diet. You don't need your own name. You don't need your own whatever else they got out there. This is not what this is about. I want you to understand that this is about an opportunity for us to have a closer relationship with the Lord. This is an opportunity for us to put some things on the table before the Lord in our sacrifice so that God can actually deal with us. Amen?
Amen.
I know I'm giving you amen on this today. When you start talking about, I know we're recording right now, but I want to say this. When you start talking about messing with black folks and their food, they'll forget all about spiritual aspect of it. They all they talk about is food. What can I eat you say? And I don't want us to go into this thinking about what we cannot eat. It's just a part of what we're doing. But we're looking at three areas in this, and that is spiritually, emotionally, and physically. And all three of those areas are critical for us in the body of Christ. And believe it or not, from the door to the parking lot, every single one of us can get better in every one of those areas. Don't lie to yourself. Don't let the devil lie to you. And while we're doing that, my prayer is that you share it with somebody else.
Yes.
So that they can join us and we can be a part of this collectively together. Amen?
Amen.
And some of us, you need a partner.
Yes.
Some of us, you need somebody that's going to check you.
Yes.
You know, to call you and say, hey, how you doing today on your second day, your third day in the fast? You need that. Amen?
Amen.
And for some of us, it can't even be your spouse. Because as soon as they ask you, like, no, but look here. You know the thing. And it shouldn't be your own thing. It should be, what does the book say you're supposed to do? So why are you an accountability partner if you don't have one? Preferably, it can be your husband or your wife, you know. But if not, find someone that you know that you can take this spiritual journey with while yet focusing on yourselves. And believe it or not, God during this time really wants to get to know you.
Amen.
Y'all hear me?
Yes.
We often say that God, it's an opportunity for us to get closer to the Lord. Very true. But it's also an opportunity for God to get to know you. Because the Bible says that his sheep know his voice.
Yes.
And the only way we get to know his voice clearly. You ever been in a situation before where you're like, I heard something, but I'm not quite sure it's God. I'm not quite sure it's the Spirit of the Lord speaking to me. Well, these 21 days give you and me the opportunity to really hear God's voice.
Yes.
And some of this time, you need to just go before the Lord and be quiet. And for some of us, that's a challenge. Because we're God for us.
Yes, yes.
So I want to direct your attention to Luke, the fourth chapter. We're up. Praise the Lord. I'm going to read a little bit of extended verses today. But just bear with me, is that okay? I'm reading the New King James Version. The Bible reads us, Luke 4, starting in the first verse. Then Jesus, being filled with the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, being tempted for 40 days by the devil. Devil career. And in those days he ate nothing. And afterward, when they had ended, he was hungry. And the devil said to him, what do you know? Here he is. If you are the Son of God, command this stone to become bread. But Jesus answered him, saying, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God.
Yes.
Then the devil, taking him up,